Hello, praise the Lord. Welcome to our brief Bible reflection as we look at the book of Habakkuk chapter 3, verse 1 and 2. And I remind you that this is a day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. By the mercies of the Lord, we have come this far. Continue putting your trust in Him. Let's walk together. Let's encourage one another. Let us keep on keeping on. God bless you. Habakkuk chapter 3, verse 1 and 2. The Bible says, this prayer was sung by the prophet Habakkuk. I have heard all about you, Lord. I am filled with awe by your amazing works. In this time of our deep need, help us again as you did in the years gone by. And in your anger, remember your mercy. Praise the Lord. The prophet reminds us that even now, we can plead with the Lord. We can just commit ourselves to Him, trusting in Him that no matter what we are facing, what we are going through, the Lord is able to walk with us. The prophet talks about having heard about the Lord, and he's saying, I have heard all about you, Lord. I am filled with awe, or, you know, I'm amazed by your amazing works, by your great works. And he says, in this time of our deep need, in this time of our deep need, help us again as you did in the years gone by. When we look at our past, the Lord has truly been gracious to us. You know, when we look at some of the things we have experienced in life, it is just by the mercies of the Lord that we are who we are today. And so like Habakkuk, we can say, in this time of our need, help us as you did in the years gone by. And he says, in your anger, remember your mercy. He's pleading with the Lord that yes, we are in distress, but we acknowledge that our waywardness, our unrepentant hearts have caused you even to look like you're so far away from us. And because, Lord, we have heard all about you. And Lord, in the previous days, we have experienced your visitation. In this time of our deep need, help us again, as you did in the years gone by. And again, because we are not so good to you, we have not done what is right before you. Lord, in your anger, remember mercy. This day, the Lord is reminding us that we can stand in the gap. We can plead with the Lord. Yes, we can look at our past and have this courage that the same way the Lord has helped us in the past, even now, in this deep need that we have, that deep need that you're experiencing, the Lord is able to help you as He did in the past. And again, His anger is not there forever. He's able to forgive us, to walk with us. He's able to remember mercy. This is a sense or a sign of humility that, Lord, we are so much in need and we can only plead with you to have mercy. And because we have seen you, we have experienced you in the past, this gives us a lot of confidence. Today, I don't know what you're facing, what you're going through. Just like this prophet Habakkuk, you can plead with the Lord. You can speak to God. You can look at your past, put your trust in God. This God who was with you in the past. This God who has helped you in the past. I love what the prophet says. Help us again as you did in the years gone by. Help us again. You know, Lord, we need you. Lord, you did it. And we know that you can do it even now. Not only to sort out our needs, but also to remember mercy. Not to consume us out of your anger, O Lord. Remember mercy. What is this that you are feeling like? You need to plead with the Lord, you know, for a second visitation. He is faithful. The prophets in the past pleaded with him. A good example is Habakkuk. And even today, you and I, we can plead with the Lord. And I will repeat this once again. In this time of our deep need, help us again as you did in the years gone by. And again, Lord, in your anger, remember mercy. Mercy upon our very individual lives. Mercy upon our families. Mercy upon our loved ones. Mercy upon his church. May the Lord bless you. God keep you. Let us continue pleading with him. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Shalom.